What's up, guys? How you doing? Welcome to another video, and welcome to the last video of 2020. New look for me, hey? Beard's gone, looking smooth, looking what, 10, 15 years younger, I reckon? Man, I wish. So today, we're going to do a couple of things. We're going to talk a little bit about a review of 2020. And we're also going to look ahead and talk a little bit about 2021. And more specifically, achieving goals in 2021. Now, 2020 has been a funny old year, right? And I set out at the beginning of this year with a few goals of things we wanted to try to achieve for this YouTube channel. And not just for the channel, but for my photography. And then some of it was kind of linked into this channel as well. In fact, we've got those right here because I kept them at the side of my computer for the entire year. Kept them over here so that we could review them as we were going. I say we, or at least so I could see them pretty much every time I sat down at my computer. And these were right here. So we had three main goals. First one was to try to shoot my first major tournament. That would have been Euro 2020. The second one was to see if we could hit 10,000 subscribers on this YouTube channel. And thirdly, I wanted to try to do something for charity on this YouTube channel. So how did we do? Let's start off with the positive, right? The first thing is that we absolutely did do something for charity on this YouTube channel. We raised some money, we donated some money to Ormond Street Hospital here in London. So many of you guys contributed to that by joining part of the Patreon community, and that was really, really great to do. I was so pleased that we managed to do something to help out some less fortunate people. Let's move on to some of the less good news. Now, the major tournament thing kind of went out of the window because there was no Euro 2020. It didn't happen. That is now going to be Euro 2021. So I suppose by default, that will kind of become an objective for next year instead of this year. Not too much we can do about that. So hey, going to draw a line under it. Doesn't matter. And thirdly, our third major goal was, of course, to try and hit 10,000 subscribers on this YouTube channel. Well, look, there's two sides to it. We didn't make it, right? We didn't do it, but it doesn't matter. We've got nearly 5,000 subscribers joined us in this community on this YouTube channel now. And that is crazy. I mean, we started off this year with about 2,000 subscribers. So we've more than doubled the size of our community just through the course of this year. Now, of course, in a funny way, COVID-19 coronavirus kind of helped with that because it gave me a lot more time to commit to making videos. And it meant probably you guys had some more time to sit around and watch YouTube videos. And that helped me out loads, which was kind of funny because alongside that, I had almost no content to use towards the channel, which is why we ended up making videos about lots of different things. And it was really, really cool to me that you guys seem to enjoy those along the way. So the fact that I'm sat here now with nearly 5,000 subscribers on this channel is crazy. Honestly, more than I thought I would achieve. That 10k was like a big old stretch goal, which I wanted to chuck out there kind of for the fun of it and to keep me motivated through the course of the year. And that certainly worked. I really felt like I committed to YouTube this year and made a ton load of videos. And I'm really, really pleased that you guys seem to enjoy a lot of those. So look, that's 2020, right? We will have some new objectives for 2021. We're not going to talk about that in this video. We're going to talk generally about how we can achieve our goals, but the actual setting of the goals will come at the beginning of 2021. But before we get to that stage, before we get to actually settling on what those goals are going to be, what can we do? And more importantly, what can I do to help you guys achieve those goals? Now, of course, it becomes very, very difficult to try to individually help every single subscriber. I would like to think that my channel and my videos, and especially where I'm talking about tips or tutorials, stuff like that, I would like to think that those go towards helping everybody. And I get so many nice comments, so many lovely comments, messages, things like that, of people saying that my videos have helped them with their photography. And that's fantastic. I really love that. And so that, of course, is a general way that I can try to help everybody, but what can I do that is even more specific than that? And I'm talking about the Patreon community that we have. We've got a really cool group of guys over there so far who are all part of the Patreon. And as part of that, they are part of my private Facebook group and private community. And my commitment to those guys and everybody in that group going into 2021 is that I am going to try to personally help those people achieve their individual goals. Part of what we're going to do in January in that group is to set some goals. Everybody will set kind of one main goal. Has to be something quite specific and something quite measurable so that we can work out how we can achieve it. And then I'm going to be including that into my own objectives to help people achieve those goals. If you think that sounds good and maybe you would like to be a part of that, go check out the Patreon link in the description. You can find out how to come and join our community over there. We do loads of other stuff as well. We do monthly live streams, other bits on there, lots of chat, sharing photos, stuff like that. Check it out if you would like to be a part of that. But in the meantime, I wanted to share with you guys some of my favourite photos of 2020. And the word favourite is fairly general, quite deliberately. That's because these aren't necessarily my most successful photos. They're not necessarily my most liked photos on Instagram. They're not necessarily photos that made me any money whatsoever. They're not necessarily the most technically perfect photos, but they are my favourites, and I'm going to talk through why. Talk to you a little bit about them and tell you why they are my favourite photos of 2020. It might not surprise you to notice that some of them aren't sports photos. That's because, in all honesty, there was a massive chunk of the year when I didn't photograph any sports, but I did keep myself busy. I was out there photographing other things, and so I'm going to share some of those photos with you as well. No messing around, let's get into this, and let me share with you the first photo. And this one is a sports photo. So this one is from the Fulham against Luton game back in February. It was the end of February 2020. Now the photo itself is nice. It's a decent photo. Colours are nice, things like that. Not necessarily an amazing photo in itself. It's a decent action football shot. But the thing I like about this, and the thing that I had no idea about at the time, is that this is not only the last game that I shot for about a 6 month period, because this was shot little bit before we went into lockdown in the UK. This also, unbeknown to myself at the time, was the last ever match that I would shoot for my old agency, Frozen in Motion. You guys have heard about Frozen in Motion on this channel, talked a lot about the fact I shot for them for several years, so real shame to not be doing that anymore, but this is from the last match that I shot with them. So one of my favourite photos of 2020. Okay, so from there we move on to something completely different. And this is actually what I've called a camera portrait. So this is a portrait I took of a camera. Now this camera was actually left to me by my late Uncle Ken, who unfortunately passed away a couple of years ago, and he left me some of his photography equipment. He was a fantastic photographer himself, had a real passion for it. He wanted some of his gear to go to somebody who he knew also had a passion for photography. Now a lot of his photography was film based, which I have very little experience with other than playing around with some of his gear. But something which I wanted to do was to try to take a really cool portrait of one of his cameras, and that's what I've done right here. Now this is one of his old Pentax cameras. It worked really well. I like the style of the camera for the photo. I wanted to try and do something in black and white, and the silver and the black kind of worked perfectly for that. It's an image I was really pleased with, and something which I'm probably going to get framed at some point and maybe get it up here in the office somewhere. Really nice photo. I really liked it, and especially kind of what it meant, hence why it's one of my favorites from 2020. Okay, moving back on from there to something kind of sports related. Not a sport itself, but it is a sporting venue. So whilst we were in lockdown, one of the things I did get a chance to do was play around with my drone. I have a Mavic Air drone, which I get to fly sometimes. I take some photos. And not too far from where I live, we have Woking Football Club. They play in a stadium which is just near kind of Woking Town Centre. And right next to it is a big kind of fielded area, a big open area without any buildings. So somewhere where you can put a drone up without it being over any kind of buildings, and you can get quite a cool photo of that stadium at Woking. And that's exactly what I did here. I really like how this photo came out, something which I was really pleased with, the colours work and the view works, and the first time I'd really tried to sort of achieve anything specific with my kind of drone photography really, which is why I really like this. This was taken when I was out, not quite on a walk, I had to drive a little bit, but then go for a walk in lockdown here in the UK in June. This photo was taken. One of my favourites. Okay, from there, moving on again. At the end of the first lockdown here in the UK, in August, there was a little bit of a gap before we went into another lockdown, and myself and the family were lucky enough to be able to take a few days away over in Norfolk on the east coast of England. And whilst we were there, I got out and about, made a couple of videos, and did some photos. Now, this is one which I took as part of a video I made about whether or not you could use an Osmo Action for landscape photography. If you haven't seen that video and you'd like to, I'll link it right here so you can go check it out. But basically, one of the things we discovered in that video is, yeah, you absolutely can use an Osmo Action to take a landscape photo. And that's what this is right here. It's a sunrise taken at the beach, at Happisburg Beach in Norfolk, which I took with the Osmo Action. I was really pleased with it, and so it's one of my favourites of 2020. Moving on from there, we actually have another photo which I took in the same location, not on the same day. I actually took this one when I was out by Happersburg Beach, kind of scouting a location ready for the next morning. And this is a photo of Happersburg Lighthouse. Now, I took this, we basically parked up, there's a car park right near this lighthouse, and we walked out of the car park onto the path, which you can see in the photo, headed towards the lighthouse. And I literally pulled out my phone, a Samsung S10 to be precise, and I snapped that photo of the lighthouse. A little bit of playing around with the colours and stuff on my phone, just in Snapseed, which is the editing program I use on my phone. And I was really pleased with how it came out. I love it. The colours of the lighthouse are cool. The sky looks really great. But it was taken on my phone, taken with a Samsung S10 Happersburg Lighthouse. Love this photo. One of my favourites. Okay, from there, we're moving back into a couple of sports photos, both basketball photos to be precise. So the first one, this is a photo of Teo Ogundembe, one of the Surrey Scorchers players, which I took out at a local park, a local recreation ground that has a nice basketball court, not too far from me, kind of the other side of Guildford in Surrey from where I live. But the reason I like this photo is this was the first sports photo that I had taken for about 6 months. A couple of the players from the Scorchers were doing their own kind of training session out there in the park, shooting, getting up shots, and they invited me down just to try and take a couple of photos of it, stuff that they could use on social media. This is one of the photos that I took. And yeah, like technically fine, it's a decent photo, but for me, it's more the moment. It's the fact that I was back photographing basketball, photographing sports after 6 months away. Really, really pleased to be out there shooting again. That's why it's one of my favourites from 2020. And last but certainly not least, moving into the last photo. This is another basketball photo. This is a photo of Lovell Cook, who plays for Surrey Scorchers. The reason I like this photo is just because I was trying something different. Now, this is the type of photo that maybe normally you would try to achieve with a remote camera. You could perhaps mount a remote kind of up under the basket, something like that. But this is actually handheld. I set this up. I set my settings. I got my exposure right. I set my depth of field to a little bit deeper. I think this is maybe like f4 or even f5.6. And I held the camera up really high, like up above my head, right up next to the basket. And when the players came in towards the basket, I fired off some frames to see what I would get. And I was really pleased I ended up with this. It's a really lovely photo. I like it. The one thing that's a shame for me is you can see in the left-hand side of the photo that the stand is empty because this is a game that was shot behind closed doors. The photo would definitely look better if there were fans filling those seats there on the left-hand side. But nonetheless, really love this photo. I love the fact that I kind of had an idea and it panned out exactly how I wanted it to and I got the photo I was trying to achieve. And that is why it is one of my favourites of 2020. And that's about it, guys. That is my review of some of my favourite photos from 2020. If you liked that, I'd really appreciate it if you hit the like button for me, hit that thumbs up, because it helps me out loads on my channel, and I really, really appreciate it. If you guys think the idea of being part of that smaller community I talked about and letting me help you achieve your goals in 2021, don't forget to go check out the link in the description where you can come along, be part of that group, and join in. I'm really looking forward to making a ton of videos for you guys next year. I've already got some ideas of things I want to do, and I've already got an idea of kind of how I want to go about posting videos as we move into 2021. For me, it's going to be less about subscribers and stuff like that. It's going to be more about making the best possible videos that we can. We're going to focus much more on the content and the posting of the videos regularly, good quality videos. And if subscribers come as part of that, great. But that's not really going to be the goal. It's going to be about making great content that you guys enjoy. 2020 has been a tough year for a lot of us. There's been a lot of strange stuff going on, and really our lives have changed, right? It's been really unique for me in the way that there was a huge period of time where I didn't really shoot any sports. Of course, it also led to other opportunities. I really don't believe that we would be here in this position on this YouTube channel with nearly 5,000 subscribers if it hadn't been for that lockdown and that period of time where I was able just to commit to making 2-3 videos per week. And I've got to say, I really enjoyed that. I enjoyed having that extra commitment to making videos because I wasn't out there photographing anything, didn't really have any other work to do, so instead I just concentrated on making some good videos for you guys, and I really, really enjoyed that. So whilst 2020 was tough, and let's be honest, for some people it would have been a lot tougher than it has been for me, and I certainly hope that all of my subscribers and my viewers have had a good as year as possible given the circumstances. I'm really looking forward to a great 2021, and I will see you guys next year.